Hey everyone, it's me, Wendy. Hope your 2018 has been going well. Ever since I did a DIY dorm decor video, there have been many, many requests to show how I actually made my own duvet cover and pillowcase set, which was featured in the video. Since it was so heavily requested, this video will show you how it's done. Mine is a plain linen fabric pillow, and it's got ties to secure the pillow on the inside. But obviously you can do this with a variety of fabrics, and you can do like buttons or snaps instead of doing the ties. I just kind of like the way they hang. If you watch until the end, I will tell you how much it cost. Also show you some different ways that I added macrame, weave, pom-poms, just like fun stuff to make the pillowcase your own. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more sewing tutorials, and I will see you at the end. Okay, we'll start with the pillowcases because they're like a mini duvet cover and I can actually fit everything into the screen. Measure the long edge of your pillow and cut out a piece of fabric that is double that length plus 30 centimeters. The width of this piece of fabric should be the short edge of your pillow plus 6 centimeters. At the two short ends of the piece we've cut, hem the raw edges by folding the fabric in twice and sealing with a straight stitch. Then take these hemmed ends and fold them in once more so that the two folded edges can touch one another when they wrap all the way around the pillow. We're going to sew these two folds in place with a straight stitch, and the purpose of these folded pieces will be to hide your pillow away once it's inside the pillowcase. Now we can fold the entire piece of fabric in half with the right sides touching and sew a half centimeter straight stitch on the two long edges. Flip that pillowcase inside out and sew the two long edges again with a straight stitch, this time about 1 centimeter away. It's not mandatory to do this stitch, but it does make the pillowcase look a little nicer. To make the ties, cut a strip of fabric that is 4 centimeters wide and as long as you can get, because there are quite a few ties that you'll need. I took that 4 centimeter strip, folded in the two raw edges, and added a straight stitch to seal it all into one flat tie. When the entire thing is sewn up, you can cut this to 25 centimeter lengths and make sure that you have 6 strips per pillowcase. On one end of each of the strips, I removed a little bit of stitching and folded in the raw edge so that I could sew it in place and seal it off nicely. Now you can attach these to your pillowcase by folding in the raw edge of the tie and sewing 2 little small stitches to hold it in place. I'm going to move on to show you how to make the duvet cover, and it's a bit of a pillowcase review since it's a huge pillowcase essentially. To do this, you're going to find a roll of fabric that you like and measure its height. We're going to call that number A. Now with your duvet, you'll need to know its length and its width, so let's call those numbers L and W for your duvet. The way this works is you're going to need multiple pieces of fabric that are as long as W plus 6 centimeters. To determine how many pieces of fabric, double your L measurement, then divide that by A, and round up to the nearest whole number. In my case, 2 times L divided by A was just over 3, so I requested 4 identical cuts that were W plus 6 centimeters long. I sewed these 4 pieces together along the long edges to form one giant rectangle, which was wide enough to cover the duvet since it was W plus 6 centimeters, and long enough to fold in half around the duvet since we did 2 times L and we rounded up from there. When you have your giant piece of fabric folded in half to surround the duvet, each side only needs to be as long as the length plus another 20 centimeters. So you can cut off anything that is beyond that to help you make ties later on. This will be a huge piece of fabric that will get everywhere, so my only other tip is to make sure that your workspace is clean. The next sewing steps are a repeat from the pillowcase, but on a much bigger scale. So first, I folded the short edges in twice and hemmed them with a straight stitch. Then I folded in the short edges about 20 centimeters in and sewed both of those folds in place with a straight stitch. Again, this is to create a flap that hides the duvet cover once it's inside. fold this gigantic piece so that the right sides are touching as pictured, and sew along the two sides about 1 centimeter from the edge. Next, I flipped this inside out, and I tried not to get lost inside, and I sewed the two sides again with a straight stitch about 1 centimeter from the edge. This is not a mandatory stitch, but again, I just do it because it looks nice. The very last step, which is the ties, is the exact same as the pillowcase. In this case, you will need to make 18 or 9 pairs of ties if you want to cover the entire opening like I did. And there you have it. This is how I made my very own duvet set. If you've been watching my YouTube videos, you might have seen it in my DIY apartment decor video. It also appears in a cozy bed inspo video, as well as a video with a tufted headboard. I'll include all of those links in the description in case you want to see any of those other bed-related decor videos. Thanks for staying until the end. If you want to see the original video with the DIY dorm decor, there is a link in the description. There I showed how to add these macrame details to the pillowcase. I also have a video coming up with CBC Life that shows how I add pom-poms and these little weave ribbons. So I have one with macrame, but I also have one now with pom-poms. And in the realm of bed-related tutorials, I also have the link to the tufted headboard that Dan and I made together. Some people have asked us where it's gone ever since we moved, and because our new bedroom has a different wall shape, it actually doesn't work to mount it in our new bedroom, so we had to say goodbye to it. If you go watch that video, watch in honor of the first DIY project that Dan and I did as a married couple, and RIP tufted headboard. We loved you while we had you. So when it comes to the cost of making your own pillowcase and duvet cover, mine actually added up to $100. There might have been more affordable solutions, but because I really was looking for a specific blue shade and I needed to touch all of them to make sure they would actually feel comfortable against my skin, this was the perfect one that we ended up with. $100 for your own duvet cover and pillowcase set is definitely not a money-saving mood. In this case, it was like a do it for the DIY kind of circumstance. That'll be it for today. If you made it this far and you didn't subscribe, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you next time. Bye. This video and my dream blue bedspread set is made possible by my amazing Patreon supporters. If you would like to support me as well, go to patreon.com/withwendy.